Hello and welcome back. This is the Clay Golem. This is Foundry VTT version 12. Thought we'd do a little bit of an experiment just to see how broken some things are in version 12, especially regarding the mods. Version 12 itself seems really nice and solid. Happy with it. But we rely on so many mods that are not necessarily updated, not necessarily working yet. I've created myself a new world here to check automations, so our automated combat, everything about MIDI QOL. So all it's got a scene here, and I've just chucked a couple of things out. Let's look at our mod list here, our active modules, standard ones that we've used before for automating combat and stuff, active auras, active token effects. Shall I read them all out, or you can pause the video, read it yourself? There's a couple on here we don't need for this purposes, but look at the colors. Okay, so the green ones are certified, verified, updated for version 12. So we know that the Carousel Combat Tracker by Ripper has been done. But look, DAE's been done as well. Okay, so that is verified for this package. Now the orange ones, they're verified for version 12, which means they haven't been fully checked or updated. But that doesn't automatically mean they don't work, because while Foundry version 12 changed a lot of things, it didn't change everything. Some of these things will still work. So that's the kind of point of this video. How broken is it? Now, I wanted to start a new world rather than loading and converting one of my other worlds in case it's a disaster, basically. Okay, so let's save that. Reload, I don't know what I changed, but there we go. I'm going to reload that. Let's come in, and of course we know, so everything's at default. I've not been through and updated all of the things yet. The only one that I did is I went through the MIDI QOL workflow settings and changed a few things, set it to the GM automatic stuff, the player's manual, etc. So I just went did a few things. Don't worry too much about the settings at the moment, because we want to see if the actual thing works, especially its integration with other bits and stuff. Okie dokie. So here we are. Okay, so let's pop onto our chat so that we can see that. Let's select these two characters. Of course, we've got Thoriman here. And straight away, Carousel Combat Tracker appears to be doing its thing. We can roll our initiatives. Yes, I've got Dice So Nice added on, although I haven't customized my dice, so they're the interesting normal ones. And we can actually start our combat. Now, bearing in mind that we are definitely going to be missing some things, we do not have gambits. That's not ready. That's not installable. And we don't have Chris's pre-mades either. We know they're being worked on. We also know that they are really, really useful for adding stuff, extra bits and bobs, but we haven't got that at the moment. Okay, so who goes first? Soryman's going to go first. We can move Soryman around as normal. We can open up his character sheet. This is all good, but of course it's the automations we're interested in. So let's target this dude here, and let's just make some, fairly standard attacks here. All right, so we're going to roll to hit. We've got our animation, we did our damage, rolled to hit, that all worked. Now I've got a little bit more text in my chat box here, because I haven't refined what messages it's putting. But we just made an attack, it checked that it hit, because it did hit, it rolled damage, and it applied that damage. And we got the animation. So automated animations is working, or at least it's that one occasion it's worked. Okay, some of them might be broken, and I suspect spells might be where we see that. But so far, it's working. It brings us a bit of hope, doesn't it? Right, next turn. This elephant. Elephant might have been a bit of a mistake to choose, because it's going to pound out the damage, something silly. Right, let's go for a gore. We're going to attack. Let's clear the chat again, just so it keep it nice and clean for you guys to see exactly what's happening. Do a gore attack. We're going to automatically roll it. It's going to miss. We've got our bit of animation, but no damage was done. Perfect as we would expect. Let's go back to Soryman's go. Make sure I change over my targeting. What else can we do here, Soryman? Let's go with a hand axe attack. Just try something different. Yep. game, we get our animation, we've got our dice rolls, we've applied the damage. That's all good. I'll tell you what would be good to check is rage working. Now, bearing in mind, rage was one of those ones that didn't work brilliantly, and we had to kind of replace it. So let's see if that's working. Got our animation. We've got our rage effect put on there. It says we've got rage here for 10 rounds, which is good. So this is all really promising. This is exactly what we would hope to see. Let's go back to this elephant's go. Now, what we want to see with rage, of course, is things like damage reduction. So we might get that on this attack here. Yes, we've hit. There's the damage. We've taken 9 points of damage. Okay, so he's raging. So it should halve his damage, and it did that. So it tried to do 19 points of damage. It's halved that round down. That works. This is really positive so far. I was expecting this to be a cacophony of horror. As nothing worked. It ain't that bad though, is it? It's not that bad at all. We've only been on version 12 for, you know, literally counting in days still, and it's okay. It's all right. Okay, so let's try something else, of course. Let's try a shocking grasp, shall we? Okay, so this is a touch range. Let's cast that. We had our animation, but we failed to hit, so it didn't do any damage, but we got our animation. That's good. Right, try something else. We might try that again next turn as well, see if we can get a hit and check the damage. Elephant. Let's try a stomp, because stomp has a saving throw attached, I think. Maybe it doesn't. So weapon attack, bludgeoning damage. I thought it had a saving throw attached to it for some reason. Maybe it's the trampling charge. Let's try that. Oh. So it's just done this. Why did I roll 2d20s? That one of them was the save, right? Trampling charge. Yes, so we rolled to hit, and we did a saving throw, and Soryman took damage as well. Okay, so that seemed to work. We had the saving throw automated as well. I wasn't watching closely enough to see if that was correct. Let's clear that chat and let's do that again. Okay, so try a trampling charge on Soryman. Soryman made the saving throw. Okay. I didn't get as much automation there as I was expecting. I was expecting more dice rolls. Oh, I see. No, it's only a saving throw. If he makes the saving throw, job done. It doesn't get trampled. That's fine. Let's try a stomp on him then. Cool. Blimey, that hurts. Okay, so that again, that's worked. And now you did notice that it came up and said he's bleeding and it's applied effect to him. That is one of the settings I changed in MIDI QOL to do that. It doesn't do that automatically. So if you're trying to replicate that, you're going, it doesn't work. Well, it won't, because I did that. All right. Now, obviously, we've got a lot of other things to test. We're only testing some real basic stuff here, but it's really promising. Automated animations is working. Our saving throws is working. Our combat, applying damage. Everything looks pretty much how we would want. There we go. Shocking grasp, and we did our damage this time, and it applied it. That's great. What about if we cast True Strike on ourselves? Yep. We're concentrating. We've now got True Strike, which is brilliant. Yes, I know he's raging still, but there we go. That has worked fine. No drama. Everything appears to be good. Now, let's see if we can get him. I'm just going to artificially bump his hit points up because I don't want to kill him right now. And this elephant hits like an elephant. So let's get this elephant to attempt to gore him again and see if that concentration works. Whoops. Let's clear the chat. Keep it tidy. Okay. Failed. We get a little animation, but nothing happens. Let's try it again. That hits. Roll our damage. And Soryman is prompted to make his constitution saving throw. He fails that. We've lost True Strike. We've lost our concentration. So while my settings aren't perfect, for example, the automation of that saving throw, they're not perfect with how I want them, because I've literally just kind of thrown it in and only changed a couple of things. We're in business. We've got to test Bless. We've got to test all those priestly things, some of the other abilities, but some of the basic stuff, Rage, damage application, damage reduction from rage, all of those things are working. This is really positive and good news. What this means is that as we move forward, we can go back to possibly some of our other areas. So one of the things I'm really nervous about is going back into places like Stormwreck Isle, which is our kind of fully automated place. You can see I've not even been in there. I've still got this triangle here because it's still verified for version 11. But going back in there, how many things are going to break? I know the one thing that is going to break for all of them is going to be Monk's active tile triggers, because that's not been updated yet. And I suspect there's going to be conflicts with the new regions. So I want to leave those for a little bit. But in theory, that should be not too bad for Stormwreck Isle. Curse of Strahd is really reliant on Monk's active tile triggers. A whole landing page is built on it. So that one is going to be absolutely trashed. So I'm just going to see where it goes with Monk's active tile triggers before I go back into there. But I might just have to rethink the whole thing. And just basically start a whole bunch of it again. The Death House will be pretty much fine. But may need to redo that one. We'll just see. We need a bit more time for Monks to get sorted, the way that we've been using it, and play a little bit more with regions and see what we can do with that. But anyway, bit of an experiment. I was expecting it to be far, far more of a disaster than it actually was, and I didn't want you guys kind of not wanting to test it because you're scared of how dangerous it could be. So I did it for you. All right. Turns out, wasn't that scary? And automated animations and MIDI QOL, which has been updated, it all appears to be working. Anyway, I hope that was useful. Version 12. We're getting there. Take care. I'll see you in the next one.